She gets to Las Vegas, New Mexico, where she first tries Mexican food. She has some nice comments on that. But her time in Santa Fe is really incredible, too, because she's drinking champagne and eating oysters in Santa Fe at this time period. So it's a really great, great journal. You know, people from this time period are long gone, obviously, and we cannot talk to them, but we can still listen to them. And that's by reading the words they wrote themselves. And to me, that's where it's at. You know, like this young society girl's journal, Louis Girard, that 17-year-old young man that came out, his journal's fabulous too. George Ruxton, the Englishman, his journal, Lieutenant Abear's stuff. All these people I just mentioned are very different, but none of them seem different from people you know today when you read their journals. There's nothing odd or strange about them at all. They're motivated by the same things, they just have different technology around them. And that ties us to people in the past. It also connects us to people in the future. It also dooms us to make the same mistakes over and over again, because when they, you know, there's all those cliche things about history repeating itself. Well, it's true. You know, the Bible said 2,000 years ago there's nothing new under the sun. They even knew then. And that's why history is important, because you, even just on a personal basis, you can't step into the future with any wisdom at all unless you understand how you got to where you are today. And the greatest gift you could ever give a political party or a politician is to not know history, because then they can really put one over on you. The more you know about history, the less likely someone's going to make a fool out of you. It's much more important than people believe, because we're the results of our past history, and the history we create is going to affect the people in the future too. So it's important. So just find that one niche you might be interested in, and then if you're really interested in it, it'll just expand you out in all directions until it becomes a sickness. And you realize you're spending more money on books than beer. That's all right. Anyway, that's the end of my tour. Thank you all.
Thank you.
And we do have a bookstore, a gift shop in the back corner of the fort back there. You might want to check it out if you haven't already. All right.